But Pastor Sue, I have to ask you, here you are, this leader and this amazing humanitarian helping families every day. How does it feel when you have to tell people that they are on the wait list and you have no room for them?
That's one of the hardest things about functioning in this role in the community is the knowledge that on any given night in Moorhead, Fargo, so we're a border community, North Dakota, Minnesota, we know there are at least 1,075 people in the community who are experiencing homelessness on any night. And there are less than 500 shelter beds in all of the shelters in the Fargo-Moorhead community. And so what we have to do, and it's always very difficult, what we need to do is we need to prioritize the people who are most likely to come to harm if they remain unsheltered for shelter beds when they open up.
And those often are parents with children. I do a lot of work with domestic violence survivors, and one of the things that it's not often talked about, the single person that, you know, who doesn't have a child, whether it's a woman or a man, who often, you know, is down the list, and I think understandably for many people, because you do want to put children and families in a safe position or people who are in harm's way. How many people were on your waiting list before the pandemic?
We've run about 200 to 275 on any given night for at least a year. The pandemic hasn't intensified that yet, although we expect that it will. There's a moratorium on evictions in Minnesota. When that moratorium runs out, we anticipate that the demand will go even higher. And that's really concerning to us because we were struggling to keep up as it was.
So the minute that moratorium is over, you anticipate and know that you will have more people at the door. How are you keeping the staff and residents safe, especially knowing that social distancing is probably very, very difficult? And again, what you just said, you're expecting more people.
We're always struggling with how do we use this space in the way that's the best possible. And then during this COVID epidemic, the challenges with trying to maintain at least some social distance, move people who are more vulnerable to areas that are a little more isolated. We've stepped up our cleaning schedules, which were already pretty intense, to just a whole nother level. We've had to make some changes in how we prepare and serve food, and that's put extra strain on our staff. We used to have like a self-serve breakfast line. And so folks who were in the shelter, whether they were individuals or family, in the morning they could come out and they could just help themselves to items off of the breakfast line. Since the COVID pandemic, we've eliminated all self-service food options because we don't want people, you know, touching two oranges before they decide which orange they really want.
Were you ever worried that you'd have to shut down the shelter?
We haven't thought that that's an option. We've worked really closely with Clay County Public Health and the Minnesota Department of Health to arrange for an off-site isolation quarantine spot for folks who have tested positive or who have had very close contact with people who've tested positive. Mm-hmm. And so we've been able to do that. We've also been able to rent a space near the Dorothy Day House in Moorhead, which is a small shelter that we also run. And we've been able to relocate a couple of folks who are especially medically vulnerable there.
You're a pastor. You will have people who say, like Job, their faith is tested many, many times throughout this. They will ask, why me, God? What do you tell them?
So I'm of the Lutheran tribe, right? And Lutheran pastors, our theology is such that we talk about not that God won't give you more than you can handle, because I think all of us at some point have been in situations where it feels like more than we can handle. For me, it's more helpful to think about no matter what comes my way, what comes our way, my faith tells me that no matter what, I'm not alone, we're not alone. Mm-hmm. And that's good news because tough stuff comes all of our way. And to know that we're not alone, even in the hard times, gives hope.